The song that you are listening to right now is played by the great jazz pianist Ramsey Lewis. And I chose this song, it's called Merry Christmas Baby, because like Ramsey Lewis, I derive a lot of inspiration from the Black Church. If you ever want to get over something, nobody knows it like the Black Church does, I will say that. And for people who get up and they tell jokes, a lot of times you're familiar with some of the sadder things in life. And I'm no different. But in the deepest, darkest places, even the faintest light shines relentlessly. And sometimes that can be a joke. It can. And so, in my household, we used to have a saying for those dark times. And we said, have faith because the Lord always delivers. They used to tell me, they said, your destiny did not get lost in the mail. Said it did not get sent to the wrong address. It said it did not get delayed. In fact, the Lord is never late because he always on time. And the Lord is never wrong because he always correct. And unlike the United States Postal Service, the Lord also delivers on Sunday. Yes, he does. Thank you, Jesus. So I came here to talk to him. Because at Stanford and many other places, we've got something called the Duck Syndrome. And what that means is that a student is looking okay above the surface, but below the surface, things are not so good. But the Stanford football team has a saying when they play Oregon. I'm sorry for that. They say they're going to pluck the duck. And that is what I came here to do, to talk to you people. Sorry, Peter. But we are going to pluck this duck. And how are we going to do it? Is I'm gonna go through some of my biggest rejections and your man's still standing. The first time I was rejected, I applied to a fancy school called Horace Mann in New York. I was 9 years old, they turned me down. It hurt so much, I was crying, it was so personal. And my mom said, the Lord gonna deliver. And we keep on applying. And when I first applied to Harvard early, they pushed me away. I told my mother about that. She started to cry. And no man likes to see his mother cry, we'll say that. But we said, the Lord always deliver. Keep on applying. Eventually I got in. And when I got in, turned down from every final club, almost every social organization, Lampoon turned me down because I wasn't funny enough. Never understood that. 100 pounds overweight. I felt sort of sad about that. But you know what I said. I said, the Lord always delivers. Never did get in those clubs. But I did get that girlfriend. And she was a big deal at that school. And I shouldn't say this, but she graduated from this very business school a couple years ago. I'll let y'all figure that out. Oh, I'm going to hear from her now. No, I'm not. She's going to act like she's never seen this tech 3 weeks later. I know how it goes. Talk to her. But brace yourselves, because there are hard times. It's true, my father died. And people who go through that, I know it's a comedy show, but that kind of pain ain't no joke. But you gotta understand that we just said the Lord gonna deliver. And there's no clear way to say it. But I say I don't have a dad on earth, but I got a Lord up in heaven. We call that man all the time. In other words, the last time I wore this tie was at his funeral. And now I wear it the same tie and tell the Alcock joke. That's how you know the Lord always delivers. Thank you. So I figured we had enough rejection there. I applied to jobs. Almost all the jobs turned me down. Even the job I took at Morgan Stanley, they turned me down the first cycle, had to apply to a different division, same time. but your man got the job. What I'm saying here is that each of you has a destiny, and if you focus on everyone else's destiny, you are going to be upset. But if you focus on your own, you can be resilient. And I got one more for you before I'm out of here. Because a couple years ago, I applied to a school I like to call the Harvard Business School. Have you heard of it? Is that place still operational? And they turned me down. Can you believe it? Oh, and they gave me a phone number to call. Find out why you didn't get in. Oh, I wish I didn't call that number. I wish I did not call that number. Of course I called that number. Vulnerable. You want the feedback. They said why you're not going to change the world, why you're not good enough, why you're not mature enough, why you won't get it done. Oh, I felt so low after everything I've been through. But you know what I said. I said, the Lord going to deliver. They're going to hear from me again. They must not know about me. Applied 6 months later, same resume, same recommendation, same essay, basically same scores, and this time your man got in. Well, that tell you everything you need to know about that process. But what stage am I standing on? The Stanford Graduate School of Business, the Stanford Law School, the school that never turned me down. And I know I'm in the right place, because if I weren't here, I would have met none of you, and I like y'all. And that's how I know the Lord always delivers. Thank you. That's it. Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank Mary Zell. I want to thank Josh Dos Santos. I want to thank God, my mom. My name is George John Jordan Thomas Aquinas Hayward. I take jokes seriously. And that is how you talk to them. Thank you.